Delaware, Pennsylvania, New Jersey, Georgia, Connecticut, Massachusetts, Maryland, South Carolina, New Hampshire, Virginia, New York, North Carolina, Rhode Island, Vermont, Kentucky, Tennessee, Ohio, Louisiana, Indiana, Mississippi, Illinois, Alabama, Maine, Missouri, Arkansas, Michigan, Florida, California, Minnesota, Oregon, Kansas, West Virginia, Nevada, Nebraska, Colorado, North Dakota, South Dakota, Montana, Washington, Idaho, Wyoming, Utah, Oklahoma, New Mexico, Arizona, Alaska, Hawaii, District of Columbia, Puerto Rico, Guam, American Samoa, Northern Mariana Islands, U.S. Virgin Islands. State, flag, order, arms. And now, we invite you to join the staff of your group training command in welcoming the graduating divisions with your applause as they enter midway ceremonial drill hall and are announced in the following order. 9-2-7. Division 927 provides your rival honor staff, honor guard, the recruit review commander, adjutant, and graduates who provide support assignments for today's ceremony. Ladies and gentlemen, you may be seated. Thank you. Divisions. Right. Face. Section leaders. Ball out and collect outer garments.
Thank you. Division commanders, left or right, face, parade, rest.
Ladies and gentlemen, good morning. I'm Lieutenant John Godfrey, Recruit Training Command's Master of Ceremonies. I would like to welcome you to today's passing review. Today, you will see seven divisions comprised of 507 sailors participating in their graduation ceremony and soon to join the most powerful Navy in the world. Please draw your attention to the unit positioned at center deck. There is the review commander and staff. The review commander is responsible for conducting the graduation ceremony. Today's review commander is construction man Cody Pelletera from Naples, Florida. Let's give him a hand, folks. Performing today is the Triple Threat Unit on their 8th week of training, the State Flags Unit on their 9th week of training, and the Staff Unit on their 10th and final week of training. These units are comprised entirely of recruits. During their night of arrival, recruits are placed in the divisions of 88 personnel and assigned division commanders. Recruit division commanders form the backbone of recruit training and are key individuals in the life of every recruit. Division commanders must serve as counselors, disciplinarians, administrators, and military leaders. Above all, they must show themselves as outstanding examples of military bearing, appearance, attitude, and behavior. Each division also has a recruit chief petty officer. This senior recruit supervises the divisional staff positions and leads the division in the absence of their division commanders. Now, ladies and gentlemen, it is my pleasure to introduce the graduating divisions, their division commanders, and recruit chief petty officers. As I introduce each division, they will raise the competitive flags they have earned throughout their training. As I introduce each recruit chief petty officer, the flag representing their home state will also be raised. Please hold your applause until all introductions have been completed. I will be starting from their right. Division 211, commanded by Chief Petty Officer Brian Mills. Petty Officer First Class Nana Obang. Petty Officer First Class Daniel Jeffrey. And their Recruit Chief Petty Officer Seaman William Wagner from Clyde, North Carolina. Division 212, commanded by Chief Petty Officer Jeremy Brooks. Petty Officer First Class Martin Russick. Petty Officer Second Class Patrick Fitzgerald. And their Recruit Chief Petty Officer Seaman Tyler Rowland from Hartwell, Georgia. Division 213, commanded by Chief Petty Officer Passion Richmond. Petty Officer First Class Austin Martin. Petty Officer Second Class Kevin Leon. And their Recruit Chief Petty Officer Seaman Gary Howard from Sacramento, California. Division 215, commanded by Senior Chief Petty Officer Larry Abram. Petty Officer First Class Randy Smith. Petty Officer Second Class Bradley Walker. And their Recruit Chief Petty Officer Fireman Isaac Mercado from Miami, Florida. Division 217, commanded by Chief Petty Officer Antonio Zamudio. Petty Officer First Class Ryan Pontifus. Petty Officer, First Class, Det Tran. Petty Officer, Second Class, Tyvon Furman. And their Recruit Chief, Petty Officer, Seaman Jonathan Dugan from Rochester, New York. Division 218. Commanded by Chief Petty Officer David Alvarado. Petty Officer First Class Orlando Lugo. Petty Officer First Class Jesse Walborn. Petty Officer Second Class Anthony Gibbs. And their Recruit Chief Petty Officer Airman Apprentice Daniel Navarro from Santa Ana, California. Division 927. Commanded by Chief Petty Officer Roosevelt Fazell. Petty Officer First Class Logan Haggerty. Petty Officer Second Class Dan Benavides. And their Recruit Chief Petty Officer Constructionman Cody Pelletera from Naples, Florida. On behalf of the Commanding Officer and Staff of Recruit Training Command, we congratulate these Division Commanders and Recruit Chief Petty Officers on a job well done. In a moment, you will see the ceremonial side boys, boatswain, and honor guard take their places for arrival honors. This time-honored tradition is our formal greeting to this morning's reviewing officer. When requested by the announcer, please stand for the arrival honors, marching honor colors, the national anthem, and the invocation. As a reminder, military guests shall remain covered throughout the entire graduation ceremony. And ladies and gentlemen, one final note. As befitting the importance of this occasion, our ceremony is conducted in a formal manner. However, we do encourage you to participate in today's graduation ceremony by letting your applause show these sailors just how proud of them you are. Once again, welcome aboard.
Divisions, attention!
Will the guests please rise and remain standing for the arrival of the official party? Recruit Training Command, arriving.
Order, arms.
Reserve Director of Maritime Operations, U.S. Fleet Forces Command, arriving.
Order, arms.
Our guests may be seated.
Color Guard, parade the colors.
Will the guests please rise? Present arms.
Thank you. Order. Arms. Retire the colors.
Present arms. Order arms. Chaplain Baraki will offer this morning's invocation.
Good morning. I would like to invite you to join my graduating shipmate and myself in this moment of gratitude and prayer. Let us pray. This is the day the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it. Eternal Father, after 10 weeks of arduous training, we gather at this glorious moment to give you thanks and raise our praise of glory for all the good things you showered upon us during our training. We lift our hearts and souls in prayers and gratitude for all the miracles we witnessed in our life and the life of our shipmates. Our shipmates were able to find friends to overcome the many obstacles of boot camp. Some faced physical obstacles, and you hold them on the palm of your hand to overcome their fears and insecurity. Some had emotional challenges, and you helped them win over their separation anxieties and made them strong, independent sailors, ready to embark on amazing journeys. Some faced mental difficulties, and you supported them and enlightened their mind to discern the need to become the best version of themselves. Some struggled spiritually, and Lord, you were there in their struggle to sustain them and remind them that you are the Emmanuel God with us. Even when things get tough and hard, you reminded us that you were the infinite love, and you call us from our comfort zone and our loneliness to join a greater cause, to join the U.S. Navy and serve our nation and fellow citizens. From the initial P-Days and all experience worries, to passing the RPC assessment halfway through boot camp, from preparing to face the challenges of battle stations, to victoriously celebrating capping ceremony. Now finally we are living this unforgettable long-awaited moment of the graduation of these new sailors, standing proudly awaiting their well-earned liberty and reuniting with their families and beloved ones. We bless you, Lord, for all the good deeds what you did for us, and we offer our gratitude for all the RTCs and staff members who helped shaping these new sailors and prepare them to go to the fleet with head held high and positive pride. Bless them, Lord, and reward them hundredfold and more. We are thankful also for our families and our beloved ones who supported us and continue to do so. Bless them, Lord, and be with them, especially when duty calls and we have to obey it. Lead us, O Lord, to port of salvation in your most holy name, that is above all names. We pray. Amen.
At this point, the commanding officer would issue orders and instructions to the unit commanders. Then, the unit commanders would face about and relay that information to their divisions. Today's events show how orders are passed through the chain of command.
Division! Report!
It's 2-1! All regiments account for, sir!
Very well.
It's 2-1-2! All regiments account for, sir!
Very well.
It's 2-1-3! All regiments account for, sir!
Very well.
It's 2-1-5! All regiments account for, sir!
Very well.
It's 2-1-7! All regiments account for, sir!
Very well. Very well.
It is 927, all present or accounted for, sir.
Very well. All division present or accounted for, sir. Very well. The Sailors' Creed. Ah. Present the graduating divisions. Request permission to commence the review.
Very well, Mr. Review.
Aye, aye, sir.
Good morning. I'm Captain Kartra Brooks, Commanding Officer of the Crew Training Command. I'm pleased to welcome families and friends to our graduation ceremony and look forward to sharing this momentous occasion with everyone. With us today is our reviewing officer, Rear Admiral Kenneth R. Blackman, Reserve Director of Maritime Operations, U.S. Fleet Forces Command. I cannot thank all of our visitors enough for your continued support, and I'm sure your sailors are grateful for your encouragement throughout their training. I would also like to welcome all the veterans in our audience for their service to our country. Would all of our veterans please stand? Let's give them a round of applause. Division 927 graduates today. They are the staff division for today's ceremony. Please join me in giving them and the six other graduating divisions here today a round of applause for their outstanding performances. This is where our Navy heritage meets the future and where these young men and women enter the profession of arms. The staff of the Crew Training Command are dedicated to providing the United States Navy with basically trained, physically fit, and smartly disciplined sailors, such as those standing here this morning. These sailors have successfully completed 10 weeks of demanding recruit training. They have earned the right to wear the uniform recognized throughout the world as a symbol of freedom. They and others like them serve as the bedrock of our naval forces. They will join other sailors around the world to give our Navy its combat edge and enable us to keep this nation secure. This training group is ready to graduate and serve in the world's most powerful Navy. Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you 507 of the newest and sharpest sailors in the United States Navy.
Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, please be seated. Recruit Training Command's competitive system among individual recruits and divisions promotes teamwork, attention to detail, and pride in accomplishment. Divisions performing above standards throughout their training are awarded recognition flags in the five mission areas: academic achievement, military drill, compartment readiness, applications, and physical fitness. These flags are carried as a visible symbol of the division's success. Each flag indicates that your sailors, individually and as teams, met performance standards in one or more mission areas. A division that excels in every phase of training qualifies for the Battle Efficiency Honor Division recognition and is awarded the Battle Honor Flag for this exemplary achievement. Division 212 has earned this honor today, and we congratulate them on a job exceptionally well done. Admiral Blackman will now present this week's individual awards, and he'll be joined on the drill deck by our commanding officer, Captain Brooks. It is our pleasure to recognize the review commander for today's ceremony, Constructionman Cody Pelletera, Division 927, from Naples, Florida. Throughout his training, Constructionman Pelletera has exhibited great pride in naval service and has consistently demonstrated his potential as an effective leader. He has maintained a high standard of personal appearance and displayed excellent military bearing and command voice. Congratulations on your outstanding achievement. Well done, sailor.
Captain David Folsom reporting.
For achieving the highest overall academic score during recruit training, Seaman Justin Folsom, Division 927 from Etowah, Texas, has earned the Academic Excellence Award, which is sponsored by the Lake Defiance Chapter of the Illinois Society of the Sons of the American Revolution. Seaman Folsom receives a letter of commendation from the commanding officer. Well done, sailor. For having displayed extraordinary qualities best expressing the American spirit of honor, initiative, and loyalty, Seaman Apprentice Tyson Hoos, Division 212 from Eagle, Nebraska, is awarded the Navy League Award, which is sponsored by the Navy League of the United States. Seaman Apprentice Hoos is presented with a commemorative plaque and a letter of commendation from our commanding officer. Well done, sailor. Seaman Robert Henkins, Division 212 from Wilton, California, is the winner of the United Service Organization Award for best exemplifying the spirit and intent of the word shipmate. Seaman Henkins is given a commemorative plaque from the United Service Organization. Well done, sailor. Seaman Jacob Thompson, Division 211 from Spring, Texas, is the recipient of the Military Order of the World Wars Award of Merit. This award is presented for meritorious performance during recruit training. Seaman Thompson is presented with a commemorative plaque from the Military Order of the World Wars. Well done, sailor. The Military Officers Association Leadership Award is presented to Seaman Jared Braun, Division 212 from St. Mary's, Pennsylvania. For demonstrating exceptional tenacity and professionalism, Seaman Braun is awarded a letter of commendation from our commanding officer. Well done, sailor. Seaman John Campisi, Division 211 from Thornton, Colorado, is the recipient of the Navy Club of the United States of America Military Excellence Award for best exemplifying the qualities of enthusiasm, devotion to duty, military bearing, and teamwork. This award places him at the pinnacle of today's newest sailors. He is awarded a flag letter of commendation. Seaman Campisi, the staff of Recruit Training Command, salutes you as the finest of this group of graduates. Well done, sailor. Appropriate to recognize such outstanding individual accomplishments by these sailors with a round of three cheers. The adjutant will lead all graduating divisions in three cheers for this morning's award winners.
I have the distinct pleasure this morning of introducing our reviewing officer, Rear Admiral Kenneth R. Blackman, Reserve Director of Maritime Operations, U.S. Fleet Forces Command. A native of Chesterfield, New Jersey, he commissioned in 1989. He deployed many times in support of Operations Earnest Will, Desert Shield, Desert Storm, Noble Eagle, and Enduring Freedom. Rear Admiral Blackman's most recent deployment was aboard USS America as Chief of Staff, Task Force 49, during her maiden transit around South America. He served as Deputy Commander, U.S. 3rd Fleet, and most recently, he assumed duties as Reserve Director of Maritime Operations, U.S. Fleet Forces Command on October 1st, 2021. Ladies and gentlemen, please join me in a warm Recruit Training Command welcome to Rear Admiral Kenneth Blackman.
Good morning, and thank you for the kind introduction. What a great day of celebration today. It's really my privilege to join you here today to welcome these 507 sailors into the world's finest Navy. For over a century, Naval Station Great Lakes has transformed over 3 million civilians into highly trained sailors. The program here has always been rigorous, demanding more from recruits than they probably thought possible. But each of them has selflessly answered the call to duty, to serve a cause greater than them. They have passed battle stations and proven themselves worthy of wearing the uniform that symbolizes freedom throughout the world, the uniform of the United States Navy. The recruit division commanders, instructors, and staff at RTC have taken on the unique and honorable challenge of shaping recruits into the finest American sailors, maintaining the Navy's high standards. We thank them for their dedication. But most importantly, we acknowledge these sailors' families and friends for the integral role you've played. You've helped shape your crew into a person who wanted to stand up for the country, who understands the Navy core values of honor, courage, and commitment. And during the past 8 weeks, you've tirelessly supported them. We now welcome you into the Navy family. Sailors, you're about to embark on one of the most challenging adventures of your life. You've chosen to serve your country at a time when it's most needed, when America must show a strong presence throughout the world, on the seas and in the skies. You've taken on the responsibility of defending our nation and are now prepared for that tremendous duty. You've earned not only mine, but the respect of a grateful nation. Congratulations, sailors. May God bless you, the United States Navy, and this great nation. I look forward to seeing you in the fleet. Thank you.
Salute of the graduating divisions, and he'll be joined on the drill deck by our commanding officer, Captain Brooks. Please remain seated until your graduates have been placed on liberty. Please join me in one more round of appreciation for our wonderful musicians of Navy Band Great Lakes. Flags. Posts. Section leaders, fall out and retrieve outer garments. Thanks again to each and every one of you for joining us on this most memorable of Navy Days. And without further delay, now hear this. Liberty Call! Liberty Call! Follow